was my introduction to musical theater.
I was very young when my mom first introduced me to The Sound of Music on television with Julie Andrews. I was probably 5 or 6.
That's when I was in 7th grade. I was 11, and we did The Sound of Music at my middle school, and I got to play Maria.
I sat on the edge of my seat, so I was told the entire time, and at intermission you had the option to buy flowers, or like a single rose that would go towards the theater troupe's funding, and of course I had to buy Maria a flower. And I went up to her at the end of the show, when they come out to greet the audience, and I handed the rose to her, and just completely starstruck. I just told her, you were wonderful.
I realized I wanted to pursue performing as something more serious. Even though I was still in middle school, it became less of a hobby. It was my first kiss.
Then I got this tour, and I felt like I'd come full circle. Well, the full circle didn't happen till middle of the tour when we were in Richmond. My mom came to the show. She'd never seen it on stage. She was completely moved by it. She loved it, and it was her birthday. So, there's where the full circle of the RNH in my lifetime has come.
I really just hold this show in such a special place in my heart, and it's nice that it'll always be a really special memory for me.
Just so happens that Sound Music was my first introduction to theater, and I think Rodgers and Hammerstein is so important and is such a classic to be used as an introductory to this industry. And I'm very grateful for it.
My Rodgers and Hammerstein story starts with the move from an apartment building to my grandparents' house. I was super excited to move in the 4th grade to Nana and Papa's, but what I didn't realize is that they weren't gonna have my toys or videos there. The only VHS available was the complete Rodgers and Hammerstein collection.
When I was little, my mom would take my sisters and I to the park, and she would push us on the swings, and she would love to sing to us. And one of her favorite songs that she would sing would be, 10 minutes ago I saw you, from Cinderella.
My favorite was Sound Pacific. To this day, I still perform Honey Bun in front of the fireplace on Christmas.
I was brought up on the musicals of Rodgers and Hammerstein. I was fortunate enough to have a household that appreciated classic musical theater.
So the first show that I ever did was The King and I when I was 8 years old, followed the year after by The Sound of Music. So my mom had signed me up for a community theater production of The King and I, and after that I was totally hooked.
Used to fast forward the VHS copy of The King and I, the second tape, I believe, to the Small House Uncle Thomas section, which was my favorite. And I can't think of a winter that doesn't go by when I don't quote to myself, and Buddha make a miracle, lace that ball from the sky.
So Rodgers and Hammerstein was such an enormous part of my falling in love with theater, with the art form, with music, with storytelling. The joy and cleverness and hilarity of it all, it bit me.
I've been very fortunate to have played both Carousel and The Sound of Music several times, and I'm honored to be on this tour sharing this great story with a new generation.
My very first show that I ever did was in 5th grade, and it was actually Rodgers and Hammerstein's Oklahoma. I played Laurie, and ever since then, it set the tone for what I wanted to do for the rest of my life.
So from a young age, the musical Oklahoma meant so much to me because my whole family was from Oklahoma. I lived overseas, and whenever we would come to America, we would stay in Norman, right by Oklahoma University. And it was the first musical I ever saw. I fell in love with it. I watch it over and over and over constantly. And it actually was like my first production outside of school I ever got to do. So it was like the first serious theatrical experience I ever had, and I got a solo, which was amazing for middle school, high school, and.
My mom sat us all down in the living room and told us that we were moving to a new state, and it was called Oklahoma, and she put in the movie Rodgers and Hammerstein's Oklahoma, and we all watched it together as a family and got really excited that we were all moving there. And when we were driving from Texas to Oklahoma, we were all singing it in the car. It
got me like thinking seriously about theater because I fell in love with Oklahoma. That was the first time I met people like me who were like doing theater.
And that was my first first introduction to musical theater in general, before that it was all country music.
In 2004, I was a new actor to New York City, and I auditioned for and booked a role on the third national tour of Oklahoma. I played the part of Court Elam, Federal Marshal. I covered Ike Skidmore, I covered Curly McLean, and I covered Judd. As a 22, 23 year old actor, I was really excited to get out on the road, and you see the contracts for the first time, and it means a lot to you, but to see Rodgers and Hammerstein at the top of that contract is actually something very empowering, and you know that you're becoming a part of something much, much bigger than yourself.
It's truly an honor to have a chance to sing the title song from Rodgers and Hammerstein's first project together.
The last time I was able to sing that song with this kind of quality in this kind of venue was 2005. And it's been a long time. So it definitely touched me in a way where being upstage center, singing my bass line, listening to all the parts mixed. I admit I backed off of my part a little bit so I could hear everybody else sing their part, because I just love the music so much, and to hear the wind-like quality of the sopranos and the hearty rhythm of the bass line and the extreme difficulty of the baritone line. Like, it is an expertly written piece.